Hello and welcome to my behind the scenes video of my little shooter project here. Well, since this project becomes more popular, I got some funny and interesting questions about this project, how I made some things and about the AI, which problems I had and how I solved it, and of course the famous bloody cam here. Well, that was reason to me to make a behind the scenes video, because I think it could be interesting for you. And yes, but before I started, I have to say that you please patient with me, because usually I make no videos with commentaries, and the next thing is I'm from Germany, so my English skills are not as good as yours. But I hope you will understand everything, and yeah, let's get started. So the first level I built, of course, was dam. And at this point, it was my very first experience with the Far Cry editor, and I don't even knew if it's possible to make this whole level. And I thought the biggest challenge could be to build the dam. To my luck, Ubisoft added a dam object, you can see here. And that was a good start for me, because I was able to take this dam and build the whole thing. And yeah, the bad thing is you're not able to enter the dam. It's a full object and you're not to enter the dam. And yes, that's a bad thing, but it was okay for me, because it was my first steps in this editor and I was happy to make this level. Later Ubisoft make updates, which was very important, and these updates and my experience with the editor followed that the following levels was with a very good quality in compared to the first level. And later in this development, it was reason enough to me to make a revise of the first level. And that's what I tried to push down the dam object and build the upper part of the dam on my own. You can see that these are single objects, and with this solution it was possible to let the player enter the dam, as you can see here. So that was a good solution for me, so I was able to make this level bigger. And yes, that was my solution for them. Let's go further to the next problem I had. So the next problem I had with the guard towers was the stairs, because Ubisoft had in Far Cry 5 only stairs like this, and these stairs are too wide, so the towers have no stairs. They are so wide as this here, and that means that the first version I had of this guard house was looked a bit different, and so you wasn't able to enter the inner area of the guard tower, because I had to push the stairs more into the tower like this here, if you can see this. And that means the stairs looked through the walls, and that isn't really nice. But in a later update, Ubisoft added invisible walls, like you can see this red grid here. And that makes me able to build my own stairs, and in this case just with shelves. This year are only single shelves, and I added this invisible ramp here, so the player is able to get upstairs without stucking at every single step. That means that I had to complete rebuild this guard tower, and now it looks more familiar. So I had to make this with every tower, included the towers at the dam too. They looked completely different, not because of these stairs, but because of the possibility to enter the dam looks completely different in the later part. So yes, I think that was the biggest things to talk about in the dam level. I mean, this secret island, you know, looks completely different in my first version too. But I want to make it like this year because I think you will recognize this. Yes, that was my solutions for them. So it's time to go to facility and runway. Well, in facility I had no big problems. It was a bit new for me because there are very a big amount of walls, and these walls are doubled because of this tile part here and this normal part above. But nothing important to talk about. But I think we can talk about the changes of my first version and my second version. Well, because Ubisoft make an update with scripts I can use, I want to make some things different just with the closed doors, because normally Far Cry has only this moment, this swinging doors here. They swing open and close in both directions, and that's not enough. You can't go and say this door has to be closed, or you can open it with a switch or with a key. That's not possible. So back then I had to add a complete closed door, so just an object, and the player had to jump through this window here. But later with the scripts, I was able to script an own door, and this door is just with letters. This here is the letter I. So this is just an I. I could use any other letters, but the I is the most sensible. So this I will disappear with the timer when the player hit this box here. The light changes to green, and it will start a script that these letters disappear one after another. But the thing is, the player can go through these letters. That means the letters will not stop the player. There are ghost letters, if you want. So I had to add a sign of this side here, you can see. And this sign will stop the player. And this sign will disappear too after you you go into this script trigger box here. This is a sign. That works very well, but that works not backwards. So I am not able to let a door close and the player can't go through this door, because after I will spawn this sign will just falling down with physics. I don't know why, but it is what it is. I have to work with the limitations of Far Cry 5. So yes, that's my solution for the doors. Yes, okay, that's on this side, nothing special. The same thing with doors on this stage. I had the solution in the past that this door is closed with barrels and more, and you have to shoot to a barrel on this side there, and that will make fire, and the fire burns to wood. And the wood will let explode a barrier here, and the door bams away. So yeah, that was my first solution, but with the scripts it works much better and more believable. Okay, facility, blah blah blah. Well, facility works fine. Here is the tank room you know. with scripts, with a slow-mo script that the explosion looks better, like more in a film. And yes, as you know, the runway level came directly after the facility level. I combined these two levels because I think the runway level for its own is too boring. It's very short, you have no big mission objectives, and yes, that's the reason why I thought to combine this level, because I don't want to upload a level so small like this year. I think it's a joke. Yes, to combine this level was a challenge, but it works fine, and I think it looks good. Yeah, I have no tank here. I know it's sad, but Far Cry 5 has no tanks, so yeah. And yeah, I wanted that the player is able to fly this plane to fly through this canyon here, and then to the goal. But what if when you destroy this plane at yeah when you destroy this plane, that will mean you can't finish the game. But in this case, I edit a script. When this plane is destroyed, you will be able to go here, and this door will be open, this gate, and you'll be able to fly by flee by car. So that was my solution for this problem, because in the original version, you are not able to end the level after you destroyed the plane accidentally. And yes, if you want to see this this level from above, you can see how small facility is in compared to the whole world map. Well, here you can see facility. That's just a small thing, and the level itself is big enough to play around a while. But it's very small in compared to the complete map. Yes. And from outside it looks just good. Okay, let's continue to the next
And
level.
now we're here at Surface 1 and Bunker 1. Well, yes, seriously, I hate this surface level. I hate to made it. It looks beautiful, but to rebuild it, it was really boring. I will make another daytime just to see more. Okay. Well, it was w really boring to build this, because it's just to form the terrain, and it's only white. It was difficult to see the shapes, and seriously, to form this was really challenging. And it was so boring for me that I made a break for several weeks, because I can't motivate myself to continue the work at this level. However, I ended it, and I don't want to talk anymore about this level. Let's continue to bunker or bunker. I don't know it in English. In this level, there are no special things or solutions, but one thing, and that's the famous bloody cam. I got many questions about this, because in my video, you can see that I shoot to the cam and spreads blood. So the reason is simple. I want that this cam can see you and make alarm and will spawn enemies. To make this, I added this trigger box, like in the facility level. And when the player hits this trigger box, a timer starts. I think it was 5 seconds or something, and you have time, this 5 seconds, to destroy this camera, and the alarm will not start, and no enemies will release and fight to you. To make this happen, something has to destroy, and this to make a trigger to no the to destroy something makes a trigger to let something happen. So the thing is, this camera is stative. You can't destroy this camera, but you have to destroy something. And I played around much to make this happen, but yeah, it was not difficult to find something that I can put into this camera and which is not too big that you can see everything what I put there. But one thing fits very good, I think, and that's a bottle of wine or whiskey, I don't know. But that means if you shoot this bottle, I mean this lens, if you shoot this bottle, the bottle breaks and you will see wine or whatever, but no blood. But that's the reason why this camera bleeds. And yes, when you don't get this, when you don't shoot at this bottle before the 5 seconds run out, on one position, I don't know where exactly, I added an enemy, a single enemy, and when the alarm hits, the alarm starts, a fire will spawn at the enemy, kill the enemy, and this enemy will spawn the second wave or the third wave to attack you. So that's a script I've wrote more or less to make this thing happen. But that was so challenging. I can't motivate me to make this script on other levels too, and especially because two cameras has to work together. And the thing is, every script can just handle 10 triggers, or no, 10 missions, objectives, however, 10 things you can let be happen with one script. And that is sometimes challenging, because I mean, to open doors, the door mustn't have more than 4 or 5 eyes or objects, because you have to make a timer and then let one eye disappear, and then a timer, and then let one eye disappear. And that costs many places in this script I can add. Yes, that's because this camera bleeds, and I hope everyone understand this now. And yes, that is the bunker lever, and I think that's enough for now. I will make a new video with the other levers. Maybe it will be 3 or 4 videos to make to handle all levers. But for now, this is it, and thanks for watching, and I hope you will have a fine weekend, and see you later.